Good evening. Respected Sri Lila Gogoi sir, administrator of this beautiful, very very beautiful temple town Yuru school. Respected Kakoli Das, main principal of this temple town Yuru school, and organizers of Shivsagar MUN, led by Director General Sri Harshit Borua, Deputy Director General Shekhar Jyoti Pangi, Secretary General Sri Ashok Dutta Phukan, and all others, office bearers, and my dear students and ladies and gentlemen. It is my privilege to attend this very gorgeous program, Shivsagar Model United Nation today. It is a very, very important platform for our young generation to understand our nation as well as the world. So, at the outset, I would like to convey my heartiest thanks and gratitude to all the organizers of this Shivsagar Model United Nations for giving me this opportunity to attend this beautiful program. I feel very honored and overwhelmed. As I am an employee of Oil and Natural Gas Corporation Limited, Assam Asset, the aim and object of the ONGC is exploration and production of oil and natural gas and give the energy security to the nation. It is also committed to for inclusive growth of the nation through the CSR, corporate social responsibility. As you know, like that Sukhapra multi-speciality hospital at Rajabari, already ONGC has given more than 300 crores. My dear students, I am a vice chairman of All India Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribes, employees of Welfare Association ONGC Assam Asset. Our main prime objective is to secure our mother organization ONGC and to protect our bona fide members according to our constitutional obligations, constitutional rights, and rules and regulations of our company. Simultaneously, we have been relentlessly trying to implement of the underprivileged section of the society in the area of education, healthcare, sports and cultural activities, empowerment of women, and skill development of the young generations. As ideology of Bharat Ratna Babasaheb Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. I think you are all know him, Babasaheb Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. He was the crusader of the social justice. He was the first law minister of independent India. He was the chief architect of Indian constitution and the champion of the human rights. So he says there, first educate, unite, and agitate. We should first educate what is wrong and what is right. What is our business? We have to understand what should be done, what should not be. So we should understand our responsibilities. We should understand our constitutional rights and obligations. At least, as a citizen of India, we should know the preamble of Indian constitution. We should keep in our mind our fundamental rights and fundamental duties as the citizens of India. And then unite, because unity is strength. If we unite, we can build a government, we can bring a government, because government is of the people, by the people, and for the people. So we should unite and make our nation. Thirdly, agitate. Agitate means not fighting our government, not anybody else. Agitate means we should understand our needs of our society, needs of our nation. We should know the needs of ours, of our society, to build our society, to build our nation. So we have to raise our voice. We have to raise our voice from by the right platform, at right place, right time. That is why this type of modern United Nations programs is very much required. That is why I already told today, I feel very honored. This is the first time I have attended this type of program. You are all, all the participants, most of the participants has come from the across of the states of Assam. So, modern United Nations, this program is very much important for youth generation, because through this program, our young generations, our students can play a vital role to build our nation, to play as a delegate of the different countries, to understand by this program, our students can understand the what is Vidhan Sabha, what is Rajya Sabha, what is Loka Sabha, what it is the nations, and the student from the very students level. So, you know, so many top leaders, so many top officers and the citizens do not know the articles of Indian Constitution. That is why they have been going very wrong way. So they are doing very wrong way, bringing our united unity and the fraternity. They are making barrier of development of our country. So we have to understand our business. So I would like to request you all, the students, my dear students, before going to lead a group of people, you should mind three alphabet letters. First D, second R, and third is P. You may remember this as my name. My name is Jambi Ram Pangi. You may understand D R P. D means discipline. Without discipline, you cannot succeed in your life. You can success one or two times, but you cannot sustain it for the future, for a long time. So discipline is the base of your life. And R means resistance. You have a strong, firm determination. You have a strong determination. If somebody says, if teacher says, if parents say, if senior citizen says, you should not do this work, then you never try to do this. Because there are some hidden reasons which are not expressible by them, but there is something reasons to avoid, advise you to avoid this. That is why, if Jesus says you should not do this, then you should resist it. Father say, my mother say, my teacher say, if this should not be done, then you should leave it. So you have to some resistance. And the third is very much required, it is called persistence. Without hard work, without your gathering of knowledge, you cannot achieve your goal. So, perseverance is very much required. So, P means persistence. Persistence is very much required for our life. That is why, first, you have to build yourself, you have to make yourself, you have to help yourself. Motivational speaker Dr. Vivek Bindra said that if you cannot help yourself, nobody can help yourself. At first, you have to build yourself, then you can help others. So, my dear students, my lecture is going to very long. I am going to conclude my speech. Lastly, I would like to congratulate all the position holders, congratulate all the organizers of the Shivsagar Model United Nations for organizing such beautiful and meaningful program, and pray the Almighty for gracing all the participants of this program and for your bright and happy life. Thank you. Thank you very much.